Traveling long distances by car or bus can be very tiring, but why is that such a common experience for drivers? All road trips require sitting in one place for hours at a time, which doesn't sound much different than sitting in a seat for a very long lecture or a movie. In fact, traveling by car isn't the same as just sitting in a chair. While on the journey, the moving vehicle changes speed due to traffic patterns, causing your body to move back and forth during acceleration and braking, while winding roads cause the body to sway as the vehicle turns. Furthermore, if the vehicle is old, with uneven seats or a rusty vibrating engine, or if the road is dented with potholes, the ride can be anything but stationary. These sways and jerks and jumps take their toll on the body, even though we're not directly aware of it. The brain accounts for movement and engages the muscles to ensure that your posture remains upright. This constant rally between the two is energetically costly. For the same reason, this is why standing hurts your legs more than walking. Trains are comparatively less tiring, as they don't accelerate and decelerate or change direction as frequently as automobiles do while driving on the road. Flying in an airplane, however, is quite similar to road vehicles when it comes to causing fatigue. First of all, there's the matter of height. Basically, your body needs to adjust to being higher up. Although the pressure in the cabin makes it a bit easier to adjust to the change in altitude, it is still far different from sitting in a chair in your bedroom. There is also dehydration to consider. Airlines maintain the pressure in the cabin by regulating the composition of the breathable air. For this reason, cabin air is 15% drier than ground air, which dehydrates passengers. Believe it or not, this is one of the many reasons that airplane food is so tasteless, or at least notably less than delicious. Perpetual noise, shuddering, rolling, turbulence, and other vibrations experienced during flight are not natural movements of the human body. The body is constantly trying to stabilize itself, leaving you tired after a long flight. When you're on a flight, you may also be hyper-aware of your surroundings. There are strangers around you, and you're unconsciously trying to stay out of their personal space for hours at a time. In other words, you're constantly on alert or worried, which is not a neutral or resting mindset for the majority of people. That's why flying business class or first class is so popular. You get more space up there, and it's much more comfortable. The purpose of business class is to make a traveler feel at home, so you're rested and ready to go as soon as you arrive. Finally, we can't ignore the psychological aspect of long-distance travel. Even the concept of travel exhausts many people, let alone the act itself. All that being said, the feeling of travel fatigue is very subjective and varies widely from person to person. If you struggle to keep your eyes open on long trips, basically, just make sure you're not in the driver's seat.